Good morning, grade 4. Welcome in your revision tutorial. So today we will revise our three chapters, the chapter number 21, chapter 22 and 23. Now let's begin with the revision part.
Okay, so look at the first picture. Have you ever seen such kind of picture when might be sometime you turn on your computer or your laptop? So this kind of picture might display on your screen. And you know what it means? It means it has a malfunction. Malfunction means, you know, there is a fail to a function normally. That means the function can't work properly or there is a failure to a function normally in a computer system. So sometimes this kind of picture have, you know, come on the screen, on your screen. So that is a malfunction. Now look at the next picture on your screen. So look at these. You know what these are? What we call, these are related to computer. We use a terminology of computer. And what these are? Have you anyone idea what are these? Yes, these are hardware devices. These are hardware devices of computer. Okay, so these are hardware devices for, you know, doing any physical work or any physical equipment. We use the hardware devices of the computer system. Like you can see a RAM, a speaker, you also see a card reader here. Then you can see the headphone, a webcam. So these are called the hardware devices of a computer. Or you can also say the physical equipments. Look at this picture. These are the input devices of our computer. And we use these equipments to provide data and control the signal to an information processing system. Why we use these input devices? So that we can, you know, put a information in a, or we can give a signal to a processing system of the computer or a laptop. So we need these input devices. For this purpose, we need these input devices. For example, scanner, we use sometimes the Bluetooth, the keyboard, we type through with the help of keyboard. Then we also use the microphones. While you're recording something, you need microphones. Then we use joystick. Okay, and then here is the, we call it a scanner, a barcode scanner we use. When you, have you ever visit the mall? Aap kabhi mall gaye ho? Aapne kabhi wahan pe dekhe jab mama ya papa bill karwate hain to wo jo uske products ke upar jitna bhi price likha hota hai usko wo scan karte hain, theek hai, aur uska barcode ya scan karte hain. So they use barcode scanner. Usko kya kaha jata hai bete? The barcode scanner, we call it a barcode scanner. Look, this is a barcode scanner. Okay, so equipments to use provide data and a control signal to an information processing system. Those are called input devices. What they are called? The input device. BIT, byte. We call it byte, and this is in a computer language, we call it binary digit. So the binary digit, what are the binary digit? Either it can be a 0 or a 1. The binary digit can be a 0 or a 1. And you know, this is the smallest unit of information in a computer. Ye kya hai bache? Ye smallest unit of information hai kisme? Computer device mein, theek hai? It is used for storing information, has a value of true or false or on and off. Isko hum kiske liye use karte hain? To store a information, okay? To store a information and has a value. Iski value hoti hai true or either it can be a false. So that is called a binary digit. Aur isko hum byte bhi bolte hain, theek hai ji? It is the smallest unit of information in a computer. Now we will go further on the right hand side. Look at your right hand side. Have you ever seen these kind of things on your screen while a mama is working or a papa might be sometime working? So you know what these are called? These are called the programming language, the language of a computer. The computer language which the computer understands. Computer don't understand our normal language. The computer has its own language. Computer ki apni language hoti hai beta, jise hum kehte hain programming language. What we call it? Programming language. And there are the different programming language. when you go to the higher classes, then you come to know, like, look at here, C++. This is also one of the computers programming language, the C++. Then we have Java, another programming computer programming language. Then we have JavaScript, Python. These are the different programming languages of the computer. What these are? The programming languages of the computer. A programming language are one kind of a computer language. Jaise ma'am ne aapko bataya ki we always write, there are different programming language of computer. Computer ki apni language hoti hai, wo apni hi ek language mein jo bhi aap information usme dalte hai usko pick karta hai and accordingly uske outputs deta hai. Jo bhi aap input dalte hai uske according uske outputs aate hai. Okay, now we will go further. Let's talk further. Now look at on your screen. Now there are more devices. You can see these are more physical devices which we use to store the programs or a data. These are the devices on the right hand side, like CD, hard drives, then RAID server, then digital cameras, then we have memory sticks, smart media. These are the another physical devices which we use to store our programs or our information. Okay, and what these are called? These are called the memory devices in which we store our data or our information so that we can use it for further in our future whenever we require it. Okay, now look at your right hand side. The more pictures of the number of softwares which we use to, you know, do the program or operation of a data. So there are other number of procedure concerned with the operation of data processing, and we use another software. These are called the software, Google software. Then we have a Word. Then we have the other software. For example, there is Skype software, video calling software, jise hum kehte hain. Then we have the Facebook. This is also one of the software. So we use different kinds of software to, you know, to explore or to get the information. So what these are called? The procedure concerned with operation of a data processing, and those are called softwares. Now we will begin with the question answer. So first I'll clear you about the basic things of the computer or the terminology of the computer. Now let's do the questions, the question answer part. So there will be a cross puzzle, cross down cross puzzle in your book. So here on the left hand side, the questions, they are in the form downwards in the puzzle, and on the right side we have the puzzles which are to the cross, in the cross direction. Now let's read the first question. Any mistake or malfunctioning of a computer, that is called, yes, that is called, right, correct, bug, that is called bug. So any mistake or malfunctioning of computer is called bug. Now let's read the second question. The physical equipment such as a mechanical, magnetic, electrical or electronic device. So ma'am told you about few of the physical devices. So what they are called? Now let's find out the answer. They are called, yes, that's correct, hardware. Yes, they are called the hardware devices. What they are called? The hardware devices. Now the question number 3 here comes. The actual data which must be put into the computer to accomplish some task. So there is a, you know, the actual data which we use to, you know, to put into the computer, jo hum computer mein dalte hain, और सो दैट कि हमारा जो एक स्पेसिफिक और टास्क वो क्या हो जाए, कंप्लीट हो जाए. ठीक है, सो वो क्या होता है, लेट्स फाइंड आउट. यस, दूज आर द इनपुट डिवाइसेस. व्हाट दूज आर कॉल्ड? दूज आर कॉल्ड द इनपुट डिवाइसेस व्हिच वी यूज टू, यू नो, टू पुट द इंफॉर्मेशन और टू कंप्लीट स्पेसिफिक टास्क into the computer. So those are called the input devices. If you remember, we talk about the different input devices. Now there are number of different input devices, like scanner, then we use a bar scanner, the other different input devices. Now we will go further. the question number 4. Let's talk about the question number 4. Wait a minute, I'll just show you the question number 4. So question number 4 refers to any equipment or a process that sends the information directly to computer for immediate processing and result. What's that called? We use, you know, one of the, you know, process to send the information or any equipment to directly to the computer so that we can immediately get the result or the processing. That is called, yes, that's correct, online. That is called online. Very good, that's correct. Now let's move to the next question. Question number 5, the digit 0 or 1, what is that? If you remember, the digit 0 or a 1 is a binary digit. Yes, that is a binary digit. Now the question number 7, the physical devices used to store the programs or the data. So there are number of physical devices. I told you, like floppy disk or a CD we use, or a Bluetooth device we use to, you know, store a data or any information in a computer or for a future. So that is called, yes, memory devices. Those are called the memory devices. And the last question, a set of computer programs or a procedure concerned with the operation of a data processing. So there is a set of programs or a procedures which we use to, you know, give operation of a data processing, that are called like Gmail, Google Chrome, or other different softwares we use. So that those are called softwares. That's correct.
We have revised a chapter 21. Now we will revise a chapter number 22. That's about a simple quiz. So here the first question on your screen that you can see, ornithology is the study. It's a study of ornithology is the study of that's birds. The ornithology is the study of birds. Yes, that's correct. And the second question here, the telephone was invented by, who invented the telephone? Yes, Alexander Graham Bell. He was the person who invented the telephone with which help we can now communicate with all the loved ones who are living far away from us. So Alexander Graham Bell was the inventor of a telephone. Now let's move to the next question. So Wright brothers are the regards as the inventors of. So the Wright brothers, they invent what? They are the inventors of aeroplane. So with the help of, you know, the aeroplane transport, we can travel from one country to the another country. And the inventor of the aeroplane is Wright brothers. Now the question number 4 on your screen, you can see, the intensity of an earthquake is measured with the, so which instrument we use to measure the intensity of the earthquake? City of earthquake. The name of the instrument is seismograph. Now let's move to the next question. The question number 5, the scientist who first discovered that the earth revolves around the sun. And the name of that scientist is Copernicus. He was the person who first discovered that the earth revolves around the sun like other planets. Now, the question number 6 on your screen here, who discovered the circulation of blood in a human body? So, who is the person who discovered about the circulation of the blood in a human body? And the name is, that's William Harvey. It's a person who discovered that there is a circulation of a blood in a human body. Now, question number 7 on your screen here, the study of earthquake is known as, so previously we talked about the you know, if you want to know what intensity of the earthquake is there, so there we have an instrument. Now, here the question is, what is, you know, the study of the earthquake is known as. So the study of the earthquake is known as seismology. Seismology is a study of an earthquake which we need to, you know, study. if you want to study about the earthquake. Next, meteorology is a science of weather. If you want to study about a weather, then you that is called a meteorology. It's the science of a weather. So this is about your chapter number 22, a simple quiz. Now let's move to chapter number 23, the odd one out. So here the first question on your screen, they have given us few pictures. Out of few pictures, what we need to do, we need to choose the odd one out. So in the first picture, in the first question, we have the number of pictures, and out of these, which is the odd one out? Yes, the figure number D is a odd one out. Others are similar. The triangle, there is a same, you know, they have the equal space leave from all the sides of the inner triangle also, then in the circle as well, and same goes to in the square. And here's the odd one out picture, that's D. Now, in the next second, we have the odd one out. That's number 34. The 34 is the odd one out from all of other numbers, because other have the same numbers, like option A is having the 33, whereas option C is having 4, 4, 44. Option D is having 5, 5, 55. But whereas in option B, it's 3, 4, 34. So option B is an odd one out. Now in the third figures, which is the odd one out? Yes, the odd one out is figure number C. Here the direction of the arrows are different, and this is a odd one out. Now in a question number 4, look at all the 4 figures, and out of all these 4 figures, which is the odd one out? Yes, the figure number C is odd one out. Now in a question number 5, we have again, they have given us the 4 pictures, and out of all the 4 pictures, the picture figure D is an odd one out. In the other picture, there are no standing line, they have a symmetry, but here they don't have any symmetry. And in a question number 6, the odd one out figure is, yes, the figure number C. This is the odd one out. And in a question number 7, we have the odd one out figure, that's option A. So with this, we have completed all 3 chapter revision, grade 4. Now I want to request you, do practice your chapters thoroughly and your exercises, and we will meet in our coming tutorials. Till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.